Welcome to the Spy Collection Digital Edition, where we are looking at spy artifacts that only exist in digital format. I'm Anastasios and today we'll present a GCHQ tool that we regularly use and you might have even captured a glimpse of it in some of our past videos. Its code name is CyberChef. This is a declassified, actively maintained, free and open source software that Britain's GCHQ publicly released in 2016. Whether you are a SIGINT analyst, a software developer, a security engineer, or anyone else working with computer systems and networks, you'll occasionally have to do all sorts of conversions. Let's say you are looking at parsing some data, but they are encoded with a certain encoder, or you are writing some software and you want to encode some text in another format. You are a security engineer and you want to turn some captured, obfuscated contents into something human readable. Or in another example, an open source intelligence analyst is looking for metadata in a photo or anything else in between. This is what CyberChef, or as GCHQ calls it, the Cyber Swiss Army Knife, is helping with. On the left side, you can select what operations you'd like to perform. In the middle, you can enable, disable, change the order, and so on. And on the right, you have the input and output, where you insert the original data and you get the result based on the defined operations. GCHQ and other contributors from the open source community are constantly extending the operations and capabilities of CyberChef, making it a one-stop shop for all sorts of simple conversions like those. At the moment, it has over 460 operations available, and apart from the publicly available online instance, since it's open source, anyone can also have it running locally, without exposing their data to any outsider. Actually, we speculate that this was the primary reason why GCHQ software engineers likely created it in the first place, so that GCHQ analysts and engineers could work on classified projects without having to perform all of those operations on their own, or develop a ton of tools to perform the same tasks. And before someone rushes in the comment section to write how GCHQ is using that to spy on the data being inserted, this is a fully open source software, meaning literally the entire code is publicly available for anyone to study. And several experts have done so without any indication that it's doing anything beyond what we just described. So, for anyone concerned, please research it and share your findings. As we read in GCHQ's press release for its public disclosure from November 28, 2016, it is expected that CyberChef will be useful for cybersecurity and antivirus companies alike. It should also appeal to the academic world and any individuals or companies involved in the analysis of digital data, be that software developers, analysts, mathematicians, or casual puzzle solvers. It is hoped that by releasing CyberChef through GitHub, contributions can be added, which can be rolled out into future versions of the tool, and is an excellent example of GCHQ providing a platform on which to base cybersecurity operations. Alright, so we covered what it does, why we highly recommend it for anyone working with computers and networks, and how it's related to our domain, espionage. But why did GCHQ decide to offer to the entire world this tiny little tool? What's in it for GCHQ? Actually, quite a lot. GCHQ launched a recruitment campaign in 2016 to attract more talent, and to do that, you cannot only say things in today's world, you have to show things. In the IT domain, open source software is a cornerstone of almost every single piece of technology out there: commercial, defense, government, academic, everything. The release of such an innocent, yet very practical tool allows GCHQ to become an enabler for IT experts on a daily basis, probably one of the best ways to advertise what people at GCHQ could be working on, and how those look like. At the same time, making something so benign open source allows anyone in the world to contribute to improve it and make it even more capable than before, thus expanding the abilities of the GCHQ team that was going to maintain it regardless. Still, as we know, most open source software is usually maintained by the original owners, but some extra help or ideas here and there doesn't hurt anyone, especially for something so self-contained and simple, which is likely another factor that played a role to its release. And even beyond all of the above, this places GCHQ in the more positive side of the spectrum for the general population, since they are practically helping thousands, if not millions of people, by simplifying some recurring tasks. Definitely a good thing for the agency's public image. So overall, GCHQ had a few things to gain and nothing to lose with this decision. But what do you think about it? Do you know about CyberChef? Are you using it? Would you like us to cover more real spy tools that you can use to improve your everyday life? Lastly, one day we'll likely learn the inside story of the release of CyberChef, which might also show us that nothing is as it seems.